What is this?
Boy, get back here!
Place your gluteal protuberances in your chair. Okay. Today, kids, we're gonna go over some basic muscle contractions. Okay. Well, to start things off, I got this overhead of a muscle contraction. As you can see here, you got the myosin head connecting to the binding sites. In the first stage, the myosin crossbridge attaches to the actin myofilament. The myosin head is bonded to ADP in a phosphate group as high energy configuration. Isn't this exciting? It's almost as cool as the Alex Trebeculi.
Yeah, it's just a killing drill.
What? Do you have menopause?
Next, as you can see, the ADP and phosphate are released from the myosin head. The head pivots and bends as it pulls on the actin filament, sliding it forward. Just like the way you slide poo forward out your butt.
Now who knows what happens in the third step? Remember, this is just simple killing drill. Don't crap yourself trying to come up with the right answer.
Okay. Well, Mr. Sharp, the ATP attaches to the myosin head while a crossbridge detaches. This is the only way the myosin head can recock in order to form another contraction.
Well, what you meant to say was, as a new ATP molecule binds to the myosin head, myosin's hold on actin loosens and the crossbridge detaches from actin. Dude, it's just drill and kill. Now, can somebody explain to me what happens in the final stage of muscle contraction?
Well, the ADP breaks off phosphate. That one simple difference makes it ADP now. And since the myosin head has ADP and phosphate back in it, it's able to cock back and get ready to start the process all over again.
Very good. Now, it's easy. It's just kill and drill. Now, can somebody explain to me what happens when your muscle gets a cramp? Okay.
A cramp occurs when you don't have enough ATP to power the recocking of the myosin head. This will leave your muscle in the contracted position.
That's right. See, just simple kill and drill. Next, what happens when an ATP splits into a phosphate and ADP?
Come on, Sharp. That's such an easy kill and drill question. All of your other kill and drill questions in the history of kill and drill questions have been easier than that kill and drill question. I've never even heard you give an easier kill and drill question than the one you just gave us. It's impossible to not answer this kill and drill, right? All the other kill and drills you've given us, I don't even think of this as a kill and drill. There ain't no kill and drill right now. Because the answer to this kill and drill is obviously ATP hydrolysis. Your killing drills have been getting easier and easier, Mr. Sharp. You gotta make them harder. Killing drill!
Very good! Now, boy, get your hands out from under that desk!